Alright guys, today we're going to talk about HoloChain Crypto and HoloSale Technologies attacking a $14 trillion global trade problem. Alright guys, if you've been on my channel for a little more than a while, you know that HoloChain is one of the crypto projects that I am very interested in because it provides so much utility in providing basically distributed hosting for people around the world. If you don't know what that means, it basically means a way, an option to replace Amazon Web Services, which hosts a lot of the websites and the mobile apps that you use every day. A lot of HoloChain right now is pure speculation because they are not live yet. They're not in production yet. I think they have a test net out where they're testing things, but that's about it. So a lot of investors right now are really, really early and they're kind of having to invest in the vision. And this video is a lot about the vision because Johnny Strang hosted an interview with HoloSale Technologies to find out what they are doing with HoloChain to disrupt the global trade problem that we are experiencing right now. So today's video, you're going to learn a little bit about HoloSale Technologies and really a lot about how the global supply chain and logistics work, because after I watched his video at that interview, I was pretty surprised at how much I learned myself. So if you haven't already yet, please be sure to smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, and now let's jump in. All right, so first I want to talk about the founders of HoloSale Technologies, because these two guys were the ones on the interview, and they were John Walker, who was in the US Marine Corps and have handled logistics in all sorts of transport. So he's basically the transporter. So he has 20 years of experience in logistics. And then there's Joey Glazer. He's a 29-year-old who has a medical background, but has spent the last 10 to 15 years studying blockchain technologies and ran across HoloChain after looking through multiple blockchains. And he's the sort of guy who's kind of like me, just reads through white papers. Main selling point for HoloSale Technologies is to automate the entire global supply chain through the cloud and provide cybersecurity. The idea is to provide service from factory to the shelf or doorstep, insurance, etc., all packaged into one package, packaged into one offering through an app that is 10x more secure than current offerings. And this is going to allow more opportunities from mom and pop retailers to big distributors. And they are currently in seed round funding. All right, so the question you might be wondering right now is, why did HoloSale Technologies pick HoloChain? Well, HoloChain is already GDPR compliant, which is very important overseas, especially in Europe. And what's cool is, let's use this example of what happens right now. It takes 12 to 15 people to touch a pair of sneakers to get that to you from the manufacturer to the store you're buying it from, for example. Now, if you're taking that example right now, you're not going to be able to find out every single one of that 12 to 15 people who touched your shoe. Now, this is not going to be good for me, who is a control freak and like to know where things are and control things. And it's not going to be for whoever it is that takes a dog and their owner is John Wick. Here's the example that they use during the interview. So what's cool is that if you buy something from China, for example, HoloSale can track the movement in real time of the parcel that is being shipped. They're currently testing a device that can read multiple data points while on a journey, such as humidity, temperature, things like that. The device is currently ready to be used. All that's left is to integrate it with HoloChain. They say that in the next week or two, they will have some sort of demo ready to show. So this is an example from Johnny Walker during the interview. Let's say we had a 20-foot container of coffee being shipped to Seattle. The manufacturer is from Vietnam, and what they do is they load up the container, takes it to a terminal, and unload it to a yard where it's waiting to go on a ship, because from North America, Vietnam is all across the world. Now, after it is shipped, it is discharged on a port on the other side of the world. So let's say Seattle's port. Then another shipping company will come in and take that container and bring it to a distribution facility. Now, at this facility, the coffee will get unpacked and sent to multiple distribution points. By that time, the purchaser might be wondering, hey, I ordered 15 pounds of coffee, but I only got 13 pounds. Not knowing that the weight was probably shaved off because it was sitting at the port for too long, sitting at the yard for too long, and it suffered from dehydration. If the coffee beans sat at the yard for 36 days before actually being shipped, yeah, it's probably going to lose some weight. Just like how when you age meat, they typically lose weight as well. Now with HoloSale Technologies, the buyer can actually get notification telling them that there is dehydration happening with the cargo that they're buying, which informs him that he's losing product. Or they can also notify him that the cargo was damaged, something like that. All right, now let's talk about the hustle. Now, according to John, the transportation legalities in the US is messed up. I mean, like, what else is new? Terminal operators would charge people for how long their containers actually stay on their yard. The problem right now is there is a lack of drivers in the US, and there is a backup of product just sitting on the terminal. So the shortage of drivers really causes people at the terminal to charge for all the containers that are just sitting there. But here's the catch. The terminal cannot prove that the container is there, and half of the time, the container is actually lost or it's actually still on the ship. So happens that there's a lot of mischarges at these terminals, which racks up the prices for the people that are buying these products. But with HoloSale, they can tell them exactly where that cargo is. There's no tech support fees, no cloud usage fees, no system upgrade fees, no cloud storage fees when you use HoloSale. So ultimately, it really, really cuts costs. Alright guys, so this is where my part comes in, because during the interview, they didn't really talk about how HoloChain fits in. Now HoloChain is agent-centric, so if you haven't watched my HoloChain videos, make sure to watch that. But what that means is that every node can basically have their own state. But what we can do is share our data, our app, etc. with each other on these things called distributed hash tables. When the data is added to that table, we can add validation rules to make that data pretty much tamper-proof, which is where the security part comes in from HoloSale. So HoloSale is really leveraging that part from HoloChain, because if the shipping data is tampered with in any way, that attempt to tamper with that data is thrown out. The validation rules lets users to really decide what kind of rules must be followed for that data to be legit. So HoloChain is completely decentralized with no need for a trusted third party, which is what secures against DDoS attacks or 51% attacks. Mainly because to launch those kind of attacks, you need a heck of a lot of computing power, and that attack may ultimately prove to be unsuccessful, which means that you basically waste a lot of money. Now, the more hosts that are going to be on HoloChain, and the more hosts that host HoloSale, the cheaper the service is going to be, because think about it. Amazon has to run their own servers at all times to host the websites that are running on Amazon Web Services. Now, if there's a blackout or if a server goes down, that means millions of dollars of lost revenue. That really can't happen on HoloChain, because if one host blacks out, then it'll just switch to another host in another part of the world to host the HoloSale app. So it's like if you have a very repetitive job that can be distributed somewhere else, if you can't do it anymore, they'll just outsource it to someone else in India or something. But that is what I'm assuming. It all makes sense to me. And that could be the main reason why HoloSale is going with HoloChain. No matter how big Amazon is, it still cannot fight back against blackouts. Also, Amazon is not allowed in China, but Holoport does sell in China, which means HoloSale can be hosted in China. And that, my friends, is a freaking loophole. That means that until China takes note of HoloChain, which right now is too small for China to bother with Bitcoin standing in the limelight always taking beatings, we can be sure that this sort of loophole running under the nose of China is gonna be running for quite some time. And lastly, HoloChain is like P2P. So you can think of it kind of like BitTorrent, which means that it automatically has security and privacy features built in. Okay, guys, I just wanna take a quick pause to show you how I learned about cryptos. When I didn't know anything about cryptos, I got started with IAM Academy. And there are some people that don't like them, but there's a lot of people that like them. And you can see here on my screen that they have hours upon hours of lives. They actually have the instructor come on a live session with you to teach you about indicators and how to trade and how to read the markets, what coins to look at, things like that. See that for some of the days, they actually have like 3 hours, which is actually most of the days, of content, of lives with you. And beyond that, if they don't have lives, you can actually go to the instructors and watch their favorite sessions. And you can see that they record their sessions so that you can learn while they're not having a live with you, then please send me an email at support@coursehack.club and I'll see you in IAM Academy. Now here's my opinion about this whole thing. If you haven't watched the video, the interview, then please be sure to check out the pinned comments in the description below and watch the video, because you'll learn a lot about logistics. But I haven't really heard of HoloSale until a viewer mentioned it to me. Anyways, it's a nice plus, but since they're not even yet in beta, I'm still gonna put them on the bonus category. Don't get me wrong, I am still bullish on HOT, but preferably I like to see things in beta or live or in production before going all hype. It's called managing expectations. But it did several things while I was watching that video. I was watching the vibe, the body language, and authenticity of the two founders. And I think that Johnny Walker really displayed that. Now at first, when he first started talking, I thought, dude, this guy sounds like a scam artist. But as I watched more and more of the video, I thought, wow, I am really learning something. This guy really knows his stuff. Cool, I think he's the real deal. Either that or he's a super good salesman and he's the kind of guy that would be able to sell me on my own poop. And I told you the three most important things: crypto, passive income, and poop. Family comes a close fourth. The usage of HoloChain and HoloSale makes a lot of sense to me, because running on the web in real time, like I explained earlier, is very, very costly if we use a centralized service like Amazon. And as far as I know, Amazon doesn't have any sort of technology that reads something like the temperature, the humidity, the touch points of a parcel. And furthermore, Amazon cannot handle blackouts when the power shuts off. Apparently, according to the interview, HoloSale has the technology to read the temperature, the humidity, the external conditions that happen to a parcel, apparently. Package that with HoloChain's ability to buffer against power outages and being cheaply scalable, we're in business. You ever bought a piece of meat and said, this meat smells bad, Someone has shat on that meat. You can't say that anymore with HoloSale because they can check it, check the touch points, and check whether someone actually shat on the meat. Gotta be careful about those Asian YouTubers. Anything to get a deal. More serious note, guys, this is incredibly similar to what VeChain does, except VeChain does this with the blockchain. Most importantly, this is all still very up in the air with my knowledge of HoloSale and HoloChain technologies, and it is all just reasoning and assumption based on my knowledge about HoloSale, HoloChain, and my experience as a software engineer. Any of what I said could be wrong or inaccurate, and you should not invest just based on the information that you get from this YouTube video, because it's half entertainment, it's half knowledge, and it's half an Asian guy talking about poop all the time, or a full Asian guy talking about poop all the time. What am I talking about? Well, this kind of news turns you on, but please take a cold shower, do more research, do your own due diligence before investing in any risky cryptos, especially risky cryptos that's really, really new, like HoloChain or HoloSale technologies. If you've enjoyed this video, if you enjoyed this content, then you know what to do. Please be sure to smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, check out these other videos on cryptocurrencies and passive income, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace!